Good afternoon, children. I think you are ready for the test paper. I'll give 5 questions. It's a case study question. Now itself, I'll not be sending it. I'll be showing it on the screen. 5 minutes. Okay, start doing. Okay, can you say this? Just 5 minutes. 5 minutes only, no extra time. Do be sincere and do it. Emmanuel, are you there, Emmanuel? Achyut? Over? Is it over? 5 minutes? Okay, 5 minutes and 1 more minute only is there. Make it fast. Okay, stop writing, children. Stop writing. Time up. Stop writing. It is enough. What you wrote, that is enough. Okay. Be sincere and evaluate yourself and check what is your score. Okay. What is the answer for the first one? Read the question. What is the first one? Option for the first one. Two schools, they want to award their selected students for discipline, honesty in the form of prizes at X and Y. P decided to award 3 and 2 students respectively with a total money, 2,300. And school Q decided to award 5 and 3 students a total money of rupees 3,700. What is the matrix equation? Aditya, for the first one, what is the answer, Aditya?
Ma'am, option A.
Option A, correct answer. Okay, option A is the correct answer. Then, Krishna Chandran, for the second one, the value of the determinants of coefficients X and Y is?
C, right.
C, correct, minus 1. Next, Nandana, what are the values of X and Y?
500 and 400.
500 and 400. Is it correct, Naureen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. The next one, what is the adjoint of the matrix A, Rijas?
D.
Option D. What do you have to do? How to find the adjoint? Just we have to interchange the diagonal elements and change the sign of the non-principal. Okay, so option is D. And for the fifth one, what is the inverse of the matrix? Achyut, fifth one. Achyut, fifth one. What is the answer? Inverse.
The option. Can you just check the option?
Option?
No, ma'am, I found the answer, but I did not check which option.
What is the answer? Give your answer.
I got A.
A. Is it correct? Nandana? Is
ma'am,
it A?
I couldn't complete it.
Okay. Srihari?
Yes, ma'am. Say.
A. So now check your score. Okay, out of 5. How many of you completed this 5 questions within the given time? Just raise your hands. Yes, Atul, Rijas, Sanya. Okay. Okay, Punya. And how many of you got 5 out of 5? Okay, so this is how you have to do for the exam, or not exam, but you do it for practice also, you have to do like this. You take one question, solve it. After solving, you check the answer. Is it clear? You take 10 questions. Whenever I'm sending some PDF, it is not taking hours and hours and you do the question. What do you have to do? You take 10 questions, set 10 minutes. After that, you check the answer. After solving 10 questions, you check the answer. Out of 10, how many are correct? Which all went wrong? Like that, you evaluate the marks and you check it. Same question paper after again, once the next week, same set, you take it and you check it, whether you are improving. Like that only you have to practice it. Okay? Okay, children. So today we are going to do some questions from last class. We started with increasing and decreasing functions. Is or no, Emmanuel? Okay, so today we are going to do questions from the increasing and decreasing functions. Okay, so here when I show the questions, don't take time for copying the questions. Evaluate and give the answer. Okay, I'll send the PDF afterwards. So that time you can solve it once again. Now read the question and try to give the answer. Okay, before we start solving, just revise it. When will you say function is increasing? When will you say the function is increasing?
If f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0.
F dash of x is positive means it is increasing. And f dash of x is less than 0 means it is decreasing. Okay. Then what about critical points? When will you say a critical point? Okay. Usually what is the method we have learned for when will you say how to find the increasing or decreasing functions? When f of x is given, we find f dash of x. We equate f dash of x to zero, isn't it? We'll be equating f dash of x to zero. Then when we equate f dash of x to zero, we will get some values for x, is or no? When we equate f dash of x to zero, for example, suppose f of x is 2x square minus 1, so it'll minus x, so it'll be f dash of x. Okay, just I'm giving an example, it is 4x minus 1. So when you equate f dash of x to zero, what is the value of x you will get here? X is 1/4, isn't it? So these values are called the critical points. So critical point means those points for which f dash of x will become zero. When f dash of x becomes zero, those points are called critical points. Okay. So suppose you are given a function. Suppose f dash of x is x square plus 1. How many critical points are there? X square plus 1. How many critical points? What is your answer? F dash of x is x square plus 1. How many critical points are there? Yes, give your answer, children. If it goes wrong, no problem. You are learning, is or no? If it goes wrong, no problem. Give the answer. Yes, f dash of x is 0. Then what you will get? F dash of x is 0 means, Gayatri?
2 points.
Yes?
2 points.
2 points. Look at here. Is it any other answer? Aditya? Aditya, what is the answer? Now what will be the answer? See, I'm giving f dash of x. No need to find the derivative. The question is f dash of x is x square plus 1. Okay. My question is how many critical points are there? What is meant by critical point? It is the values of x for which f dash of x becomes 0. Okay. It is the value of x for which f dash of x becomes 0. Now, f dash of x is x square minus 1. The question is how many values of x you will get? Yes, Sania. Rijas.
Two, ma'am.
Two. Any other answer? Gauri? Dia?
Zero.
Zero. Why?
Root of negative.
Yes. Actually, the answer is no points here. Why? X square plus 1 is 0. So x square is negative 1. Is it possible? When you square a number, will it be negative? You have to apply all the concepts what you have learned. Square is negative 1. So no real value. Okay, here no real value at all. Because it is negative. If it is plus 1, then it is correct. If x square is plus 1 means x is plus or minus 1, so you'll get 2 values. Okay. So here we will not be getting no values at all. Okay. Now let's do this question. Okay, can you see this, children? Okay, So answer the first five questions. Answer the first five questions. Solve the first five questions. Okay, make it fast. 5 minutes. 5 questions, 5 minutes. Yes, children. What is the answer for the first one? The function f of x is equal to 9x plus 8. What is the answer? Ashwin.
True, ma'am.
True. Okay, when you find f dash of x is 9, which is always positive, isn't it? Now, Rin, second one, f of x is equal to x square.
A.
A. It is decreasing in the interval minus infinity to zero. Is it correct, Emmanuel? What is f dash of x? F dash of x is 2x, isn't it? And 2x will be negative if x is less than zero. So it is minus infinity to zero. What about the third one? Punya, third one.
C.
C is wrong. Any other option? Srihari.
A.
A is the correct answer. Very good. Why? What is f dash of x? Minus 3 by x square. Isn't it? It is given as strictly decreasing. Look at this term, 3 by x square. 3 by x square is always positive. It is always positive. So here, the negative sign is there. So it is negative for all values. But what happens when x becomes 0? It is undefined. It will become infinity. So minus infinity to infinity minus 0. Next, fourth one, Dia.
A.
A, it is strictly increasing. Okay. E raised to x is always positive. The derivative of e raised to x is always positive. Okay, suppose the question is like this, f of x is equal to e raised to minus 2x. What will be your answer? Suppose f of x is e raised to minus 2x. Then what will be your answer? Yes, Diya, try it.
Increasing.
Is it increasing?
Decreasing.
Decreasing. Okay, if it is e raised to minus 2x, f dash of x is e raised to minus 2x into minus 2. E raised to minus 2x is always positive. But here we have negative sign. Because of that, it will be decreasing. The next one, fifth one, Achyut. One. Achyut is present?
Yes.
Fifth one.
True.
True. Okay, just find out f dash of x. F dash of x is negative 7, which is always true. Therefore, it is decreasing. Okay. Now the next set. Okay. So I'll give some selected questions. Do only those questions, not all questions. Okay. So now, sixth one, eighth one. 8, 9, 6, 8, 9. Make it fast. 6, 8, 9. Similar questions only. I'm leaving children. The remaining. So 6, 8, 9. Then those are completed. Do the 16th, 17th. Answer or attendance. Okay, 6, 8, 9, is it over, children? 6, 8, 9, is it complete? Okay, now listen, children, listen, all of you. So sixth one, what is the answer? F from R to R given by f of x is 2x plus cos x. Atul, what is the answer for the sixth one, Atul? What is the answer? Here, one more question. What is there? Maxima or minima, isn't it? So, first you find whether it is increasing or decreasing. Okay, look at here. That question is a different question. F of x is 2x plus cos x. Listen, look at here. F of x is equal to, what's the question given here? 2x plus cos x, isn't it? Gauri, question, is it correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So, I'm finding f dash of x. 2 minus sin x. What is f double dash of x? It is minus cos x. Is it correct? Now, to find maxima or minima, what is the first thing we will do? F dash of x is 0. First order derivative is 0. Listen, children. So if it is 0, 2 minus sin x is 0. So sin x is 2. Is it possible? Sin x, will it become 2? What is the maximum value of sin? Maximum value of sin is 1. Isn't it? It will never become. So it will not be getting a value equal to 0. Then, so the options, maxima, minima, it will become not correct. So the only possibility is you have to check whether it is increasing or decreasing. Look at the derivative here, 2 minus sin x. From here, what you can say about the sine of f dash of x? What about the sine of f dash of x? What is the maximum value of sin x? It's 1, isn't it? So 2 minus something means surely it will be positive. Okay, it is always positive. So we can say f dash of x is increasing. Okay, is increasing. Okay, now try the next one. 8th one. Make it fast. Then only we'll be able to do as many questions. Values of x for which y is equal to x into x minus 2 the whole square is an increasing function. What will be the answer? So y is x into x minus 2. So don't expand it, to keep it in factors itself. Similar questions are there in your textbook also with factors, with square or with cube. 2 or 3 questions are there. In miscellaneous exercise we have. In exercise also we have increasing, decreasing functions. Okay, y is x square into x minus 2 the whole square. What will be dy by dx? Use product rule. Uv, so x square into, if you differentiate this, 2 into x minus 2 plus x minus 2 the whole square, you keep it as such. Derivative of x square, it is 2x. Don't expand it. Now, take the common terms outside. We can take 2x into x minus 2 as common. Therefore, what is left out? Here, 1x is there and plus x minus 2. So we get 2x into x minus 2 into 2x minus 2. So it is same as 4x into x minus 2 into x minus 1. Is it correct? We can take 2 as common. So we get 4x into x minus 2 into x minus 1. Therefore, what are the S?
Can you explain the third step again?
From these two steps, what is 2x plus x? Derivative, then we take the common terms outside. Here we have x square, here we have x. So you can take common term outside. Again, 2 is common. X minus 2, here x minus 2 whole square. Take the common terms outside. And then you group the, simplify, you'll get that factors. You'll be getting linear factors. So the values of x are 0, 1, 2. Therefore, the whole number line minus infinity to infinity, we get 3 values here. Values of x as 3. You're getting 3 stationary points here. Now, you split this into 4 intervals. Which are the 4 intervals? Minus infinity to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to infinity. Okay, so in minus infinity to 0, you select one value, minus 1. Substitute in the last term here, dy by dx, in the factors form, and check what is the sign. If you put minus 1, what will be the sign? Is it positive or negative? You put minus 1. Krishnachandran, what will be the sign? Krishnachandran, and you put x as minus 1. Negative, because first term is negative. Here also minus 2, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So it will be negative. So negative. So what we can say, f of x is decreasing in the interval minus infinity to zero. Now, in the interval 0 to 1, so in the interval 0 to 1, you take the value 0.5. If you substitute 0.5, the first factor x is positive, but what about 0.5 minus 2? It is negative. 0.5 minus 1, that is negative. So positive into negative into negative, so it will be positive. So f of x is increasing in this interval. Now you take the next interval 1 to 2. You can take 1.5 and check the sign. First factor is positive, second factor is negative, but the third factor is positive. So it will be negative. So we can say f of x is decreasing. Now 2 to infinity, you can take some value 3. So if you look at, when you substitute it, it is positive. So f of x is increasing. So from here, what you can see, is it increasing or decreasing? In which, what is your option here? It is increasing, isn't it? Increasing in which interval? Select the interval. Similar question only, the ninth one also.
A.
Option is A. For eighth one, option is A. Similar question only, ninth one, okay? Don't allow, okay, don't expand it again and again. You keep the factors as such so that you can check the sign easily. If you expand it, checking the sign will be difficult. You keep it in factors. Michael, what about the second one? Started doing the second one or not? What is dy by dx in second one? Yes, Michael.
In question 9.
Yes.
Oh, I got answer is A.
Ninth one answer is A. Yes. Yes, answer is A, ninth one. Then look at the 16th question, children. Is it over? Is it clear, children? Now look at the 16th one. F of x is tan x minus x.
Ma'am, 9.
Yes.
Can you tell what you'll get when differentiating?
When you differentiate, what you'll get? Give the answer. What is the answer? What is the answer you got? What are the factors you got? Ninth one. Yes, Sachit, when you factorize it, when you differentiate it, what you will get? It is 1 into x minus 3 the whole square plus x into 2 into x minus 3. So if you take 1 x minus 3 as common, x minus 3 plus 2x, accordingly, you will get the factors. What is the factor? 3 into x minus 3 into x minus 1. Okay. Now look at the 16th question, children. Tan x minus x. What is f dash of x?
Ma'am.
Yes.
So we have 0, 3 and 1, right?
How will you get 0? Is there any x term there?
No.
So only 1 and 3 is there. If x term is there, in the previous question, we had x. So we put x is 0. Here no x term. So it will be 1 and 3. Okay. Now look at the next one, children. 16th one. That is again an important question. Tan x minus x. Find out f dash of x. Sec square x minus 1. What is the answer? Gauri?
I didn't complete.
F dash of x is 6 square x is minus 1. Here no need to solve all those things. Instead of that itself, you can give the answer. 6 square x. But,
always increasing.
Always increasing. 6 square x means it is positive. A positive value. Okay. It is tan x minus x. Now look at the next case. F of x is equal to sine x plus cos x. Okay, this one also is there in our textbook. So first make it thorough with the questions given in the textbook. If you are thorough with the questions in the textbook, you can do all these MCQs easily. F of x is sine x plus cos x. So it will be f dash of x. It is cos x minus sine x. So f dash of x is 0 means you will get tan x is equal to 1, isn't it? So x is 45. X is pi by 4. So we get the interval as it is from 0 to pi by 2. In 0 to 90, we get one value as pi by 4. So in the interval 0 to pi by 4, what about sine x minus cos x? In pi by 4 to pi by 2, what is sine cos x minus sine x? In which one it is positive, in which one it is negative. If you take 0 to pi by 4, you can take 30, isn't it? Pi by 6. Cos 30 minus sine 30. Is it positive or negative? In 45 to 90, you can take 60, pi by 3. Cos 60 minus sine 60. So in which interval it is increasing, in which interval it is decreasing. It is increasing in the interval, whether sine 30 cos 60, okay, 30 and 60 are the values you are taking. And accordingly, you check. Take 30. What is the value of cos 30? What is cos 30, Rijas?
Root 3 by 2.
Yes. And what about sine 30?
1 by 2.
1 by 2. So which one will be bigger? Is it cos x minus sine x? Will it be positive or negative?
Cos x minus sine x. Positive.
It will be positive. Root 3 by 2 means 1.7 by 2. So you'll get, okay, you'll get 0.7 something minus 0.5. So it is positive. So it will be increasing in the interval 0 to pi by 4. It will be increasing in the interval 0 to pi by 4. Okay, 19th question is the model we have discussed earlier. Okay, look at the 18th one. This one is also enough, is from our textbook. Okay, children. Okay, with this we wind up. So what do you have to do today? I will send this PDF. Try to solve the questions in this PDF. Okay. Thank you, children. With this.